नमस्कार, आई एम नंदू यादव एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल लर्न एचटीएमएल विद नंदू यादव। सो टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज फॉर्म डिजाइनिंग इन एचटीएमएल। एवरीबडी नो द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ फॉर्म। द फॉर्म्स आर यूज्ड टू कलेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन, कलेक्ट डेटा फ्रॉम द यूजर एंड नीड टू प्रोसेस। व्हेन यू वांट टू नीड टू प्रोसेस, वी कैन प्रोसेस दिस। सो द फॉर्म्स आर एसेंशियल थिंग। And these essential forms are created by using HTML also. So we are creating here form in HTML, and these HTML forms are created by using this form tag. Let us see step by step how we can create this one. Okay, now we are going to check all input controls, all basic input controls of form, step by step, one by one, practically. So we are check one by one. The first element or first input control, that is the single line text box. Before that, we should know that to create a form in HTML, HTML provide the form tag. HTML provide form tag. This form tag is a paired tag and its closing is compulsory. So that is the opening and closing form tag. All the form elements are placed within this opening and closing form tag. So first we create here the form opening form tag and closing form tag. Within that we can insert all input controls. But rather than that input controls, we can also insert images, tables, all other text. You can also apply multiple heading levels here in our form. Only one thing you can't do in form, that is the nest form, that the nested form. That means we cannot insert another form within a form. That is the nested form. लक्षात येते तुमच्या, that the forms create करते वेळी एका form मध्ये दुसरा form आपण insert नाही करू शकत. That is the nested forms are not allowed here in the form tag. Okay, now let us start one by one input controls. The first input control is single line text box. That single line text box is used to collect a single line information like name or email address, etc. So we take here or we collect here information in form of name. So our label is a name, and to collect name you need to insert, that is the input tag. So input type equal to text. This input type equal to text insert single line text box on the web page. Okay, let us see. Only input type equal to text insert a single line text box. Practically, when we check this, we can here save this file and here we can see its output. Here, that is the name is our label, and in front of that name there is a single line text box, and in this single line text box we can write our or the collected information, name in form of name. So name we can write here, that is a name. Here the informations are collected. See here, name, we can write here name, but all the information here are collected in a single line. So this one is the single line text box. Suppose we want to add insert another, that is the address, another form, that is the address. And address, specially address, are displayed in a multiple line. So we need to use another input control, that is the multi-line text box. Okay, so to insert a multi-line text box, HTML provide this tag, that is the text area tag. This text area tag is also a paired tag and its closing is compulsory. Clear? Now we compare single line text box and multi line text box. Single line text box are inserted by using input tag, whereas multi line text box is inserted by using text area tag. Here the input tag is a singular tag and text area tag is a paired tag. Okay, one by one sequentially we will add attributes of both input as well as text area. The first attribute, that is the name. Remember, each and every input control must have a name. So it's compulsory attribute, we can say that the compulsory attribute, that is the name, we can give a name here. Name is, that is the, we are collected here name, so we can give, that is the name in short form, that is the NM. Here also we are going to collect address, so we can assign name here. So name equal to, in shortcut we can give, that the address. Clear? So first one single line and second one, that the multi-line text box. Both text boxes are collected text or other numerical data also. Okay, but there is a limitation to the single line text box in form of to collect information in a number of characters. Text area can collect information in form of multiple characters, that is a large amount of data is collected by using this text area tag. So when you want to collect a large amount of data, we need to use text area tag. Okay, here we can use a value attribute of input tag. This value attribute here, when you use with the single line text box input, then it gives a default value. Suppose I write here that the Sachin Tendulkar. When you give a value with input tag while use with the type text, then this value is displayed as a default text. See here, default text of the single line text box. See here, Sachin Tendulkar is a default value of him. Here also, multi line text box. For the multi line text box, there are other attributes, that the first one you already write, that the name. Suppose you want to control the height and width of the multi line text box, HTML provide rows attribute, which increases the height of the multi line text box, and the value is given in numerical, that the rows equal to 5, that indicates the multi line text box height is a 5 rows in height. Okay, so the value is given in form of number of lines. You can also increase the width. So to increase the width, we can write here calls attribute, that the HTML provide us calls attribute, and the value for this calls attribute is given in form of number of characters. Remember, number of characters. Okay, suppose you want to display the all input controls one by one, line by line, then you need to use here p tag, or you can break the line by using br tag. Okay, see here, we will save this file first, then checking here the output. See here, our first input control, that the single line text box, our another is multi line text box, and multi line text box here we set the value in a 5 lines. See, 5 lines means here all the contents available in the multi line text box are displayed in a 5 lines. That means you can view the contents of 5 lines at a glance when you set the value of rows equal to 5. And if you check here the width, then it up to 40 characters. Clear? Okay, that one is the single line text box and multi line text box. Now we can see another attribute of multi line text box. We can use its another attribute, that is a wrap. Wrap, it controls the text wrapping behavior of the multi line text box, and the values provided to wrap in HTMLs are, there are three values. First one, that is the off, OFF, off. Second one is soft, and third one is a hard. When you set the value of wrap as off, then here, and when you type in the multi-line text box, no text wrapping will occur and it displays the text in a single line continuously. Okay, that is the wrap equal to off. But when you set the value of wrap to soft or hard, then the text type in a multi-line text box will automatically wrap to the next line without pressing enter. That is the text wrapping behavior of multi-line text box. Okay. So today we discuss two input controls of the form single line text box and multi-line text box. Remaining input controls we will see in our next video. So keep watching. Keep learning. Thank you.